The Florida Panthers are the hottest thing on ice. This cat has carried the offensive explosion, while others show they can also light it up. After sweeping the four-game homestand, the high-powered Panthers take to the road for the next two games, looking to travel the swagger. It starts with a date in Dallas, tonight on Bally Sports. Is presented by BMW, the ultimate driving machine, official luxury vehicle of the Florida Panthers. The Cats go for their fifth straight win in Dallas at 22-7-4. Panthers second overall in the NHL standings. They could be number one by the end of the night. Sergei Bobrovsky goes for his personal fourth win in a row, backed by that powerful Panthers offense that's averaging an incredible six goals a game during the winning streak. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Dallas, Texas. Steve Goldstein along with Randy Moeller. And if you were at any of the games at FLA Live Arena, you saw an offensive show by this Panthers team led by Jonathan Huberdeau.
Yeah, and they're going to try and duplicate it here on the road. And 16 different goal scorers in that four-game homestand, all wins. Yeah, having fun, filling the net, outscoring opponents 24-10. Jonathan Huberdeau, Anthony Duclair. Huberdeau's got 9 points his last three games. And how about the power play? It was excellent. The Cats caught four. The sweep all four on home ice. And the Panthers, again, shooting that puck, out-shooting opponents. And big wins, Alexander Barkov leading the way. And how about Sergei Bobrovsky as well? He was outstanding when called upon. Patrick Hornquist, the veterans, Bobrovsky up to 15 wins now, including a 47-save gem Tuesday over the Flames. The big question, can they do it again now on the road for the next two?
Yeah, trying to get it going on the road. Andrew Burnett talked about it this morning. Now, only 4-4-4 on the road this season. Now, Panthers going with the same forward lines. And let's talk about the Losterinen line. They have been together all year, and they've been terrific.
Yeah, I call them the fun gun and have some more fun line. Boy, they're fan favorites for the Florida Panthers. Ryan Lomberg, he's causing havoc every game and scoring some big goals for the Cats. Etu Loisterinen getting jumping on those rebounds. Solid up the middle. He's now got four game-winning goals. And how about the Aegis Wonder? Patrick Hornquist, key on the power play. He got two the last outing against the Flames. Combined four goals, 9 points for that line, that energy line for the Panthers. They'll be counted on here tonight in Big D.
And Dallas, a stingy defensive team. Braden Holtby in goal. How about these two guys? Joe Thornton for the Panthers and Joe Pavelski of the Stars. They played more than 1,000 games together as teammates in San Jose. For the second time ever, they go against each other. And it's Thornton's 1,700th NHL game tonight. Get inside the nets. Our Discover matchup tonight. Sergei Bobrovsky with that blistering record. When you look at Braden Holtby, and very similar numbers there, nearly identical in the goals against and save percentage. Holtby, the veteran, the former Washington Capitol, won the Stanley Cup in 2018. Dallas has been a stingy defensive team. So once again tonight, the high-powered Panthers, number one in the NHL in offense, go against a team that doesn't give up very much. And Joe Thornton, how about this? He'll get the start tonight for Andrew Burnett. Thornton is playing his 1,700th game.
Amazing. And he's still going and still loving the game.
He's got Vetrano and Tippett on his wings. There's his buddy. Look at that. He against Pavelski in the faceoff circle. They played 1,029 games together as teammates in San Jose. This the second time ever they have been opponents. And there is Thornton taking the hit from Hintz. Tippett takes the puck. He has a chance. He shoots. Holtby the save. Golden opportunity for Owen Tippett walking in all alone. He's got it again. Tippett backhander through the blue paint. And finally Hintz is from the same hometown as Alexander Barkov. Tampere, Finland. Aaron Ekblad comes in tonight, eighth in the NHL amongst defensemen in scoring. We'll hear from him at the first intermission about playing with Joe Thornton. He had some terrific things to say. Panthers forward lines are the same, only change tonight on defense. Olli Juolevi back in there for Lukas Karlsson. And here is Juolevi with the puck. he'll carry to center.
Yeah, Olevi, he can skate with that puck a lot like the other Florida Panther players.
That puck was touched with a high stick.
Let's take a look at the Panthers' first scoring chance here tonight. Kind of a giveaway. Thornton just numbs it forward, goes off the skate there to the defenseman, and Tippett all by himself. I don't think Owen Tippett realized he had that much time and that much space. He could have walked in and tried to tuck it underneath the crossbar. Oh, it's been a tough goal, scoring goals for this young man. He's getting his chances. Now, you know, the coaching staff have told him, just keep shooting the puck, keep going for that net.
Lundell's line with Huberdeau and Duclair now out there. Lundell has been playing great hockey, 4-game point streak. Gouda shoots, save, it goes up off the crossbar and then on top of the net. It stays in play and behind. Gudas nearly had one there. And Lundell trying to clear, but Lundell blocked that. Anton Lundell feeds it in front for Huberdeau. Chipped away, Lundell gets his stick back. Haskinen's got it for Dallas. Duclair blocked the clearing attempt. Here's Lundell, it rolled on him. Gudas trying to keep it in. And now Esa Lundell will clear to center ice.
The Dallas Stars looks like they're having a little trouble. They're handling that puck coming out of their own zone. As you mentioned, Billy, haven't played in 17 days. Could be a little rust in their game.
In the last game, December 20th, they were shut down with a COVID pause. Hornquist off a two-goal game the other night against Calgary. Gillespie pinches in, puts it behind the net. Osterinen went down. That's Peterson for Dallas working it free. And Joel Kiviranta will flip it out to center ice. Panthers come in, second overall in the NHL, a point behind Tampa. They played two last games in the Lightning half. Tampa home tonight against Calgary. In fact, top six teams in the NHL, all in the East, three in each division. Bomberg got a loose puck, chipped away though. Now here comes Hintz, moving in for a chance. Centering pass, Podolski's shot blocked. Bobrovsky covers up. Get to our Papa John's key ingredients to tonight's game.
Well, Dallas is pretty strong up the middle. They're excellent in the face-off circle, so the Panthers have to pay attention to those face-offs. Alexander Barkov was excellent on Tuesday against the Calgary Flames. And the Panthers, how about this? Barkov with 15 shots over the last four games, including seven on Tuesday. Keep those shots coming. Those are my keys. We'll see how the Panthers succeed in those departments.
Dallas, one of the best in the league in the faceoff circle, and they've got many of them, so a big factor will be how the Panthers, no, after the faceoff, can they get to that puck? Barkov up ahead for Maxime Mammon over the line. He'll give it back to Barkov. Takes a shot off the stick of Hintz and up and out of play. Let's get to our Taco Bell take tonight.
Well, let's take a look where the Panthers stand as far as scoring goals. And you know, after the 24 goals and that four-game homestand, yeah, they're right at the top of the NHL. Vegas right behind them. Of course, Colorado, the high-flying Avalanche, and the Washington Capitals with Ovechkin.
And the Panthers trailed in three of the four games at home. No one in the league has more comeback wins than the Panthers, both overall and in the third period. What a season Florida's having. Only seven regulation losses. And they've only lost by more than a goal four times. I mean, they're in every game, every night. Glendening, the veteran, dumps it into the Panther zone. Faxer rides Uyghur to the end boards, and Uyghur went down awkwardly there. Stars work it free, but Harley couldn't handle it. Tippett on the forecheck with a steal. Good play by Tippett. Drop pass Petrano. Back for Tippett. The shot off the post. Oh, and Tippett had all of that one on that wrister. Couple of great chances early on for Tippett, getting himself in position, and that time he made the defensive play to create the chance. Here's puck now at the Panther line. Anthony Duclair's got it. Carries in, hands it over to Lundell. Ooh, he took a hit. Went down. Lundell gave him the shot. Here comes Ben, and he'll shoot in. Sagan getting after it against Forslund. Picked up by Gurianov, puts it in front. Good job by Gudas, right in front of his own net. Huberdeau trying to get it out of the zone, he does. Huberdeau comes in tonight, fourth in the league in scoring. Only Draisaitl, McDavid, and Ovechkin have more points than Jonathan Huberto. And he's doing it all in all facets, not just the offense. Radulov down low, chipped away by Loserinen. Those two battle to the boards. Yalevi in the battle as well. Radulov has it though. Centering fade up high. Suter moves it along. Here's the shot. And Klingberg had it deflected away. Bobrovsky grabs it in the glove.
Well, interesting comments by Andrew Brunette, the Panthers' interim head coach this morning. He says, you know, everybody talks about our home record at 18-3, but he says, we got to establish that kind of success on the road. And here's a big opportunity here in Dallas Saturday in Carolina. Panthers come in with the least amount of road games in the NHL so far.
Now, the big disparity early on this season, few of them were missed in the postponement when they had the nearly 2 weeks off. Great start at home, the second best home start in NHL history for a team. Panthers clear to center, Mammon trying to get there, but the veteran Suter and LaPlaya, then Mammon gets a hold of it and backhands in. Klingberg's clearing attempt deflected, but it's out to center for Hagee trying to jump on the puck. He moves in, centering pass all the way through the slot. Hagee last season had the hat trick. The game here in Dallas, of course, they played each other so many times, all the games last season. In the abbreviated COVID season, we're in the same division. Now it's Barkov, leaving it for Ekblad. His shot blocked, Ekblad again, puts it high over the net. Forsling sends it around the boards. Back the other way, Loserinen, good hit there on Glendening. And the Panthers control. Dudas' pass was knocked away by Robertson. What a talented young player he is, one of the most underrated players in the NHL. Top line left winger for the Stars.
Now the Dallas Stars did just sloppy passing so far in this first period. You can tell they haven't played in a while, and the Panthers trying to take advantage of that.
Here comes Hintz, breaking in. He moves it on the backhand. Big save by Bobrovsky. Sergei Bobrovsky, early on with the big stop. Now Lomberg trying to go the other way. Gathers it in, takes a shot. Hope he makes the stop. Bobrovsky picking up right where he left off the other night. He gave up a goal, the second of the game, 10 minutes in. He stopped the rest of the shots, 41 in a row against the Flames. 47 saves, the second most in his career. He has 52 for Columbus against the Panthers way back when in 14. Here's Ben over to Sagan, stolen away by Montour. Yalevi behind his own net, around the boards. Ben is there. They give to Gurianov. Here's Sagan wrapping it on goal, but Bobrovsky is there again. We are just underway tonight in Dallas. Panthers trying to win their fifth straight. Big stop by Bobrovsky, keeps it scoreless. They put it up on the scoreboard. Nice hand from the crowd. Many on their feet. Of course, they watched him for years as an opponent when he was with the San Jose Sharks.
Incredible numbers. 429 goals, over 1,100 assists.
But he chose to come to Florida to try to win that first Stanley Cup of his career. Now back in 2016, Thornton, along with then teammate Joe Pavelski, now of the Stars, made the Stanley Cup final, but it was Patrick Hornquist and the Pittsburgh Penguins that were able to get that victory. Hornquist won it back-to-back in 16 and 17 with Pittsburgh. Off the draw, we'll do it again. Sagan got the shot away, and those set plays the Stars try to do off the faceoff. They're dangerous. There's a look at Jumbo Joe.
Still loves to play the game, come to practice. Everybody talks his work with the young players, the Florida Panthers, both on and off the ice.
Sagan, stopped by Bobrovsky. Lundell clears ahead. Huberto tried to get it ahead to a breaking Duclair, but that puck rolled on him a bit. Ekblad and Ben go to the end boards. Lundell took a hit there from Sagan. Weegar takes the puck. Stretch pass for Huberto at the line. He'll find Weegar. Spins with it. Feed over to the boards. Huberto gets it back. Weegar straight on. Over to Aaron Ekblad now. Ekblad trying to get in front. He does. He couldn't get a clean backhand on net. Nice move there by Ekblad. Huberto for Weegar again. Sending it in front. Anthony Duclair with a shot blocked away. Huberto jumps on it again. Pressure by Florida on this shift. Finally chipped away by Heiskanen to the line. And Gurianov will get it out. Long shift for this Stars line, so Sagan will just flip in.
Another couple of excellent opportunities for the Panthers, starting with Aaron Ekblad stepping in.
Panthers right up there, league leaders in high quality scoring chances. You get an icing call here on the Panthers.
Yeah, after Aaron Ekblad with his chance, walking along the line, then watch Duclair come in here. Goes off the skate of the defenseman, right onto the stick of Duclair. And Braden Holtby come flying out of the net. Another look at it from a different angle. Look at the attack mode there of Holtby. I mean, he got bumped and spun around. Anthony Duclair, what a stretch he's having. 4 goals and 6 points in his last 4 games.
Little argument there. Ekblad thought he was on the bench already. On the icing, they pull him back out. Barkov's line on the ice. Roppel pulls the faceoff back. Put into the slot. Barkov takes away lead pass. Verhaeghe gathers it in. Trying to get a step to the net. Verhaeghe gets it on goal. Save. A penalty coming up. They tied up Verhaeghe. And the Hot Panthers power play will go to work.
Yeah, that's the speed of Carter Verhaeghe. Never gave up on the play. John Klingberg is going to go to the penalty box. Here it is from the faceoff. Panthers sweep it. Look at that forward pass off the boards. And the quick first step there by Verhaeghe sets up that partial breakaway, and then he draws the penalty. Panthers are red hot in the power play, Goldie. They got 4 power play goals the last 3 games.
Set up quickly. Aaron Ekblad over Huberto. He'll shoot. Save up high. Huberto gets the rebound right back. Hornquist out in front of the net. Here's Huberto. Barkov, he scores! Huberto with another point. Barkov with a power play goal, and the Red Hot Panthers lead it 1-0.
Well, you remember going back just a few games before that homestand, the Panthers are struggling on the power play, and one of the reasons why they weren't finding the open man and moving the puck quick. Well, go to the front of the class here, this power play, because that's exactly what the Panthers do, and they're able to freeze the defenders. The Panthers move it around, they win the draw, that's number one, and there's Huberto firing that shot, then regains control of the puck. Now the Panthers. Look at here, Ekblad gets it back to Huberto, and there's Barkov right in the middle of the ice for the one-timer.
You know, I felt like it was inevitable. It was a matter of time. They're just too talented, you know, to stay struggling the way they were on the power play. Barkov gets his 13th goal of the season. You know, he missed all that time with injury, but if you project out his numbers, he's on a 50-goal pace for a full year. 13 goals in 21 games. Panthers have the lead. Hornquist ahead for Lomberg, and he'll dump it in. Huberto came into the game, second in the NHL in assists. Gets the primary there. Now has 10 points his last 4 games. Ekblad got the second assist on the Barkov goal. Lomberg with a steal in the offensive zone. Hornquist went down along the boards. Lostarine and put it towards the net, and that's covered up by Holtby.
All right, let's take another look at this power play goal. I'm going to break it down for you. And this is a set play. Okay, the Panthers with full control. Once Ekblad puts it back to Huberto. Now, hold it right there. Now, Huberto, there's Barkov, and he's waiting. He's already got his stick in the air, and he's anticipating that pass. And it's just up to him, pure talent, to pick the corner and Holtby.
Barkov's 5th game back after missing basically 6 weeks of hockey. Remember, he played most of that 1 game in St. Louis. Thornton put the draw to the boards. Montour gets a shot away. Saved by Holtby. Montour again. But he has to come back to center. Montour had his best game as a Panther offensively. Last time out against Calgary with the 3 points. All assists. That tied a career high for him. The veteran Radulov back in his own zone. Niskanen. Up ahead, turned it over. Here comes Verhaeghe, breaking it over the line and shooting, and Holtby way out to make that save on Carter Verhaeghe.
Again, the Panthers taking advantage here of some miscues by the Dallas Stars. Here's the Stars, full control, come out of their own zone. They try a risky cross-ice pass and right onto the stick of Verhaeghe, and we've seen him score some big dandy goals from that position off that left wing.
The Panthers have now scored goals in each of their last 12 periods. Gotta go all the way back. First period out of the pause, they didn't score against the Rangers. They've scored in every period since. Forsling takes a shot, ooh, just wide of the net. Barkov is there in front. Radek Batsa got it out to center. Panthers on it again, but they'll call a hand pass as it hit Forsling's glove. Panthers are back home next Tuesday night against Vancouver. You can get your 50-50 raffle tickets now. They are doubled until puck drop, so get them on the FLA Live app or visit FLAPanthers5050.com. There's Tuesday against Vancouver. The next weekend, the Panthers are home. Friday and Saturday, it has been showtime every night in South Florida when the Panthers play at home. Incredible. Winning and doing it for the high-flying offense. Barkov at the blue line. Nice feed. Verhaeghe breaks it again. Verhaeghe to the backhand. Stop. Mammon on the follow. That's blocked away. Holtby is down. And the Stars get it out of trouble. Carter Verhaeghe is flying tonight.
Yeah, what a pass, too, by Alexander Barkov to set up that offensive push.
Verhaeghe's broken it all alone a handful of times, including the one that drew the penalty. Panthers scored on the power play. Now Pavelski in the offensive zone. But back to pick it up is Lundell. Lead pass. He's got Duclair. Breaking down the wing, drop pass. Lundell shot up and out of play off a stick. Panthers offense pushing here in the first. The veterans, Huberto to Barkov for the first goal tonight. The power play, but it was Verhaeghe off this rush that created the power play chance as he is held going to the net. That takes us to our in-game jackpot brought to us by the Florida Lottery with the Panthers. Saw an example of it there. Number one in the NHL in rush chances, first in the league in quality scoring chances. You see, Dallas defends both well, so it's kind of a offense versus defense matchup. So far, the Panthers winning it. Verhaeghe with three shots on goal in the game. Huberto with a lead pass. Duclair. Drop pass. Ekblad. He's got a chance. Blocked away. Gets it right back. Duclair behind the net. But taken away. And Joe Pavelski backhands. And now gets out. Rope hints in front for Pavelski. That's broken up. Nessa Lindell puts it up for Dallas and breaks in. Rolls towards the net. Jonathan Huberto. Bumped by Robertson, absorbs the hit, makes the play. Huberto has just elevated it to a whole new game. What a year he's having. Aaron Ekblad said this morning, mentioned MVP for Huberto in the conversation.
Why not?
Hornquist in front, knocked away. Buck bouncing around up at the line. Kiviranta backhands out. Olajuwon will send it right back into the Dallas zone.
And, you know, going back to Jonathan Huberto, everybody talks about the offense and now 10 points in the last four games for Huberto, but the defense as well. Breaking up plays, coming back with the back check. And the, you know, big component of the Panthers' penalty kill.
That's been a new wrinkle. And, you know, really not interested at all when he's talked about himself. All he talks about is winning. I've been here 10 years. It's time to go to the playoffs and win the playoffs. Thornton trying to get it in front. Oh, it hit the post. It just stayed out. Now Montour in the follow and hope he makes the save. Joe Thornton nearly had one from that sharp angle. Gurianov the other way. Puts it out in front. Tipped away by Montour. Panthers have won, and they've come close a handful of times, but now on a turnover, Gurianov in front, deflected wide. Free puck in behind the net, it squirts side of the cage and covered by Bobrovsky.
Braden Holtby, he got spun around here in the last scoring chance for the Panthers. He didn't know whether to wind his watch or steal second base. There it goes off the post. He's looking for it. Where is it? And Klingberg, his defenseman, was able to clear it momentarily. There's another shot of it. That's a good angle. That's how close the Panthers came to taking that two-goal lead.
And Montour had that follow shot.
Now it looks like Braden Holtby is getting a little equipment adjustment now. He's probably dizzy from spinning around in the crease.
Panthers have been all over him. 20 shot attempts already in the game for the Panthers. They hit the post a couple of times, that one, and tip it earlier. Did you expect this from Dallas, you know, being off for this long? You know, you have that rest versus rusty thing.
Yeah, and the Panthers, they're very aware of that, taking advantage. The Panthers, with their speed and the way that they anticipate, when they've got the forecheck going and they're able to get into those passing lanes of the Dallas Stars so far in this period, and they've intercepted numerous outlet passes that have turned quickly, and then they go for the offense.
Keep an eye on that blocker of Holtby.
Yeah, it looked like he shaken up on that blocker hand and lost his stick.
Klingberg off the faceoff takes a shot here and he scores, and Dallas ties it just like that on one scoring chance.
A redirected shot. And it looks like Michael Raffel's going to get credit with this one. We talked about the face-off prowess of these Dallas Stars. There they win one clean, and back Klingberg gets to the middle of the ice and just floats one towards the Panther goal. You'll see what Bobrovsky's looking at right there. And no doubt, nice deflection there by Raffel.
Well, Dallas didn't have much going on, but they're very good off the face-offs. Not many guys that can take them, and on that play, Klingberg got a look. So we are even. Apple's fourth of the year. Huberdeau back in his own zone, finds Uyghur. Duclair at center, trying to get down the wing. Lindell is there with him. Duclair works it free. Huberdeau in front, great pass to Uyghur, and it's kicked out by Holtby. Quality chance by the Panthers off the rush. But Holtby made the save. Another great play by Huberdeau to set up a teammate. Now Lomberg breaking the other way with speed. Lomberg goes wide and shoots. Another save by Holtby, that one with a shoulder. Panthers just firing pucks to the Dallas net here in the first. Montour clears the center. Oster in and over there, but couldn't control the puck. Montour turns back. 1-1 game here in the first, 6 minutes to go. Mostarinen took the bump. Yolevi takes the puck and he has room as he moves in. With a pass to Montour out of his reach. Yolevi stays after it. Now it's Tippett in on the forecheck. Stars able to clear. Boxa got the second assist on the goal. He won the faceoff. Got back to Klingberg. Peterson now with a shot, saved by Bobrovsky, and a good one. Puck is loose. And finally, we get the whistle. Panthers were boxing out at the net after the initial shot. Opening period in Dallas, we are tied.
Example, the Panthers transition game. Here they get control of that puck. Here's Uyghur up the middle of the ice, and we're not talking, finished talking about him yet. And there's the setup by Huberdeau. Uyghur's the trailer coming in. They're able to isolate that defender down low. And Claire finds some open ice, and then the quick hands there of Huberdeau timed perfectly to hit Uyghur right in stride.
Panthers still without Reinhardt and Marchman, and now Spencer Knight as well in COVID protocol. Jonas Johansson is the backup goalie, and Sam Bennett serving the second of his three-game suspension. Here's Klingberg again, shooting. That went wide, glove side. Verhaeghe, one-on-one against Suter. Now Mammon going to the net. Verhaeghe floats it there, but Suter blocked it away. Two-on-one develop. Good hustle by Mammon getting up in the play. Barkov settles it down at the line. Took a hit from Glendening. Forsling sends it right back into the Dallas zone. Suter controls, though, and able to get it ahead. Vajilov. Raffalo has the goal tonight for Dallas. Puts it back behind the net. Forsling with a little bit of room here. Forsling for Lundell. He'll fire in to the open corner. It bounced away from Huberto. Here's Kiviranta down the boards, taking a shot, bad save. And Anton Lundell is on the rebound. Swept back the other way, knocked off Pavelski's stick. The player end of his shift will slot it in.
And then the Panthers are having some great success here in this game so far by spreading out the defenders of the Dallas Stars with those long outlet passes.
Here comes Hintz, shooting high, and it goes out of play.
Well, what can you say about Jonathan Huberto? Comes in now, he's got 10 points in the last four games. And where does he stack up with the leaders in the NHL? Comes in fourth in the National Hockey League. Connor McDavid did not play in their game in Toronto last night. Another loss for the Edmonton Oilers. Amazing season for number 11, Jonathan Huberto.
Hintz against Losterine in the circle. A couple of fins going at it. Panthers get the help after the draw from Ekblad. It comes all the way down, but it will be icing. They'll do it again. Panthers are on the road Saturday night, wrapping up this quick two-game trip in Carolina. What a game that should be. And you can join the Panthers for the Funky Buddha Watch Party Saturday night. There'll be giveaways and more. Go to FloridaPanthers.com for all the information. Panthers beat Carolina earlier this year at FLA Live Arena. Hurricanes right there with those top teams in the NHL, as mentioned, all in the Eastern Conference. Point shot here was deflected away, never got to Bobrovsky. Hornquist gets the red line. Mostarinen throws the body in on a forecheck. Hornquist went down. Lomberg with a check, but it comes all the way down the ice. Weegar gets back. This Dallas top line getting a lot of ice time. Hintz, Robertson, and Pavelski. That one goes over the glass and out of play.
Aaron Ekblad will play close to probably 25, 26 minutes tonight, maybe even more. Ekblad's third in the National Hockey League in defenseman shots. Came in tonight with exactly 100.
Thornton's line back on now for the Panthers. Gudas lead pass, tip it at the line. Trying to get it over to Petrano behind him. Petrano spins it down low. This is Thornton. Sticked away by Sagan, but nice hold in by Petrano. Frank Petrano, top of the circle, looking for some help. Down the boards for Thornton again. Better round for Ben. And now it's Ryan Suter. Lead pass to center, broken up. Good stick by Forsling. And the Panthers are right back in the offensive zone, but Petrano couldn't handle it. Cleared out to the neutral zone. Jamie Benn stripped away from behind by Thornton. Here comes Montour. Up ahead for Verhaeghe. Moving and shooting, and a save by Holtby. But for Verhaeghe, for the second time in the game, off the rush, draws a penalty, and the Panthers will go on the power play.
Yeah, and again, the Panthers draw another penalty off that transition. They just turn so quickly once they get possession of that puck. There it is right there. Faxa with the slash before Verhaeghe was able to release that shot.
And what a game Verhaeghe's having already.
A little jump in his step tonight.
All right, one for one on the power play. And goals in four straight for the Panthers. That matches a season high, trying to reclaim their lead. Huberdeau's got it. Try to thread it through to Duclair, but it was deflected away. Ekblad moves it over to Huberdeau. He'll settle this puck down. In front, Duclair. Back it goes. Ekblad straight on. He's got a chance. He shoots. It goes wide on save. Here's Huberdeau again. Skipped away, and the Stars have a two-on-one. Shot blown over the net. Oh, Glendening had a look, elected to shoot, but missed high.
Big break for the Florida Panthers. And good interception there. Glendening coming down on the two-on-one. Decides to take it all by himself. And puts it into the net. Above the plexiglass.
Glad watched by Pavelski. Now it's Duclair. Getting the speed going through center. Over on the wing, Hornquist, and he skates. Hornquist digs it free and sends it around. Huberdeau jumps in after it. He'll give to Duclair. Now Barkov up high, who has the goal tonight. Hornquist out in front. Braden Holtby. Huberdeau. Cross ice. Barkov. Ekblad. Barkov. One-timer saved by Holtby. Comes into the corner. Pavelski went down hard. Panthers work it back up high, but it jumps over Ekblad's stick. They've got to reset it. Huberdeau, great move, gets it back to Ekblad. He shoots, deflected wide. Oh, what a play there by Huberdeau. Hornquist lost it at the net. And the Panthers will have to change the power play unit. That's a great zone time there. Ekblad looking for an open man, couldn't find one, so he's got to shoot in. Owen Tippett, stripped away by Ben. Montour looking for one more rush to man up. He'll slap it wide of the net. Big Karen, taken by Haskinen, stripped away by Lundell. Now Owen Tippett as the power play ends. Tippett has a chance, he shoots, blocked away in front. Tippett, good hit on Glendening. Suter now. Gets it out to center ice. Here comes Glendening. Turns with it with 10 to go in the period. Gives back to Klingberg. He's under heavy pressure from Mammon. Oh, it's a penalty on Mammon. He got the stick in there.
Now you can see the frustration there of Mammon. He thought he played it perfectly, keeping himself between Klingberg and the net. Dallas Stars there get the control of the puck, and there's the hook right there. It's unfortunate Manor only had one hand in his stick, but he was able to get it caught in the jersey there at Klingberg.
Well, they get a faceoff here with 5.4 to go in the period in the Panthers zone. Panthers able to control that and get it to the boards. And that'll do it for the first period. Each team scoring once.
Well, the Panthers, again, they just replicate what they were doing on home ice by creating the scoring chances with the speed and causing those turnovers in the transition game. And 19 shots on goal for the Panthers, and they had a boatload of scoring opportunities.
Here's what's coming up at our first intermission report. Stay with us. From Dallas, we'll talk to Alexander Barkov in just a moment live. We'll have all the highlights, and we'll take a closer look at that four-game homestand for the Panthers. What a run they went. The Cats in Dallas tonight, a 1-1 game. After this, they'll head to Carolina. What a matchup that should be. The Panthers and the Hurricanes Saturday night at 7 here on Valley Sports.
Very similar teams. They got great speed, excellent goaltending, and they love to score off the rush as well. Frank Vatrano's had some success. Anton Lundell has scored some big goals as well, and the Panthers took the first meeting.
As one of those games, the Panthers came out storming. Four goals in the first period. Taking it 2 the Hurricanes. Two of the best home teams in the NHL. Of course, the Panthers are number one, but Dallas with those point percentages in the top five.
Yeah, this is only their 16th home game and only three regulation losses. Jamie Benn, the captain, the catalyst for the Dallas Stars.
So 1-1 heading into the second period. After this road trip, the Panthers head home next week, Tuesday, Friday, Saturday at FLA Live Arena. And hey, that Panthers premiere plan is on sale now. Come watch the best show on ice. The Panthers 18-3 at home. The plan includes the weekend games, holiday games, premier opponents. Go to floridapanthers.com now. Get your tickets. Still half a season of regular season hockey on home ice. And the Stanley Cup playoffs. There's Huberdeau and Barkov. Last two out of the dressing room. Sergei Bobrovsky has been terrific of late, Randy, trying to win his fourth in a row.
Yeah, he's won 5 of his last 7, coming off that 47-save performance on Tuesday night over the Calgary Flames. And he'll be front and center here to start this second period. The Panthers are shorthanded, almost a full power play, 2-minute power play for the Dallas Stars, their first opportunity.
And for whatever reason, you know, Bob's always dominated Dallas. There's a look at his career numbers against the Stars, unreal.
Talk about players that get into the zone. And you see his routine right here. He does it before every period, before every game.
Barkov and Lundell, the Panther forwards on the penalty kill with Ekblad and Weegar back on defense. This is Dallas's first power play of the game. Panthers PK during the winning streak, killed off 10 of 11. Suter, watched by Lundell. Lundell knocked it away. Puck is loose at center, fed ahead. Here comes Barkov. Looking to get a chance. Barkov to the backhand. What a goal! Alexander Barkov, an amazing shorthanded goal to give the Panthers the 2-1 lead. He's got both of them tonight. Oh, man.
Well, the Dallas Stars, they were just stunned here, and the individual effort of Alexander Barkov. I'm going to show you the reason he got in. Here he is. He's going in on the defenseman, and right, stop it right there. There's that stutter step. And now, okay, roll it. And he's got a step on the defender, and then that long reach, he just reaches around and then drags the puck to himself on the backhand for another shorthanded goal for Alexander Barkov.
Just dazzling from Barkov. Second of the game, 14th of the year. My goodness. Barkov is back. Now deep in the Panthers zone, Huberdeau on a loose puck. He looks to break out to center. Two Stars all over him. Huberdeau able to move it over the line, taken back the other way by Klingberg. Weegar got a stick on that. Lostarinen back there to help. Panthers get it up the boards, but Klingberg is there. Now it's Pavelski. Klingberg got the assist on the Dallas goal, takes a shot here, knocked down in front, then sent wide of the net. Vajilov. Klingberg again at the blue line. And that one redirected slickly by Robertson behind his back, but it went wide. Panthers get a steal, unable to clear, but now Lostarinen will get it out.
A couple of deflections there on the shot attempts by the Dallas Stars with Bobrovsky. Good positioning, maybe we'll get a stick on it.
Lomberg is moving with Lundell. It's a two-on-two. Anton Lundell cuts to the slot and fires. Glove save by Holtby's. Got a hold on. Panthers just go offensively, whether it's even strength, shorthand, it doesn't seem to matter.
Anton Lundell, such a huge part of that penalty killing. See him talking with Lomberg there.
Lundell, seventh in rookie scoring now. And he's up to third in the NHL in takeaways. Amazing. Weegar is tied for first in the league.
And you just add to the most faceoffs taken and won by a rookie so far this year.
As Bill Zito said publicly, he's met and exceeded their expectations at 20 years old. Heiskanen for Ben. He has a chance. Bobrovsky makes the save, and then it goes in through his legs.
play goal. They came in tonight fifth in the NHL in power play goals. Panthers got caught on the far side, and here's Jamie Benn, takes the shot. Bobrovsky looked like he had it, and then it squeezes right between his legs. And then it just rolled over the goal line. Here's a look up above.
And not sure if Gurianov ever touched it or went in off Gudas's stick. So the Stars again answer back a Panther goal. They did it in the first, a little more than 4 minutes after Barkov gave him the lead. They do it here in the second, about a minute and a half after Barkov gives him the lead. 2-2 game, 5-on-5. Both teams scoring on that Dallas man advantage. Verhaeghe lead feed, Mammon is in. Maxime Mammon, great move, Barkov, and he's stopped by Holtby. Barkov looking for the hat trick, but Braden Holtby makes the save.
Again, the play that develops for the Florida Panthers back in their own zone, and how quickly they move that puck. And the Dallas back checkers just out of position, and there's Mammon just set it right onto the stick of Barkov, just couldn't lift it over Holtby, or else he would have had his third of the night.
They do give the Dallas goal to Gurianov right now, his fifth of the year. Say he got a piece of that puck. Bobrovsky made the save, but it was sitting at that goal line. Panthers again with another great chance off the rush. Heiskanen shoots, Bobrovsky stops it. Barkov sends it around the boards. Heiskanen there to pick it up. Another shot, steered away. Barkov hard after that puck. Montour sends it around, and it's Verhaeghe for Barkov again. Verhaeghe at the line, they're offside.
Two goals in the game so far for Alexander Barkov. The Dallas Stars are trying to match lines. I've been watching with the defense pairs, especially with Klingberg, their big defenseman out there with the Barkov line. So far, they've been unsuccessful in stopping that number one line. Verhaeghe, we saw some of the chances that he created in that first period.
Only one goal scored in even strength in this game of the fourth. Bobrovsky sent that over to the boards. Evie Ronta tried to wind it around and hits the netting and out of play. Lundell got an assist, by the way, on that Barkov goal, so he has a five-game point streak. The Panther record for a rookie is 6, done by Alexander Barkov, Kristen Husilius, and way back, Jesse Belanger did it, so Lundell can match that on Saturday. He has come out of this COVID pause and just played great hockey.
Yeah, I know you've mentioned a couple of times. I think that time off really did some wonders for Lundell. These young players, especially playing in your first year, the stress level and the anticipation of playing and practicing and can wear on you, especially mentally.
Of course, still without Bennett and Reinhardt, he's stepping up and centering that second line.
Yeah, getting a great opportunity. You know, playing with players like Anthony Duclair and Jonathan Huberdeau. He's earned every minute of ice time.
Ekblad got the other assist, so a two-point game now for Aaron Ekblad. Came in eighth in the league in points. Monk's defense adds to that. Backhander towards the net, Bobrovsky to save the follow shot. He stops that, and finally we get a whistle.
Wow, that's the one player you don't want to get in behind the defense, and that is Joe Pavelski. And you see Bobrovsky having a little conversation with his defenseman. Here off the draw, another win by the Dallas Stars, and they just pitchfork it towards the goal. Pavelski got in behind and positioning on Ekblad. Bobrovsky was able to find it and freeze it up.
Klingberg for Robertson. He takes a shot off the glove of Bobrovsky. Puck loose side of the net. Weegar with a big hit there on Pavelski. Pavelski keeps on battling. Lundell is on him. Taken away by Weegar. And the Panthers get it out nicely. Duclair knocked off his stick before he could move it forward. Pavelski the other way against Forsling. Pavelski, the pass behind Klingberg. Bill Pavelski in 2021, over the last season and this season, played every game for Dallas, one of only two stars, somehow at age 37, is pacing for career-high numbers. No dip in his play. Here's Gudas shooting high. Forsling takes a shot right on, and he scores! It found its way in! Hornquist was out in front of the net. The Panthers have their third lead of the night.
And I think Hornquist is going to get credit with this goal, and that'll be his third in the last two games, including tonight. Hornquist goes right to the front of the net. As soon as that puck goes back to the point, you'll watch him come into your picture here. There's Hornquist, gets position, and yeah, he's deflected that puck behind Holtby.
Talking to Hornquist before the game, he mentioned Thornton's 1,700th. I said, you're about halfway there. We had to look it up. He's at 848 now. And heating up offensively, Patrick Hornquist. That's a big goal for the Panthers. They get their lead back again. It's 3-2. Gloster in it. Lead pass deflected. Holtby left it there for Harley. Steal by Lomberg. Up the boards it comes. And cleared. Icing.
Well, this goal doesn't happen unless Gustav Forsling has the initiative to get that puck to the front of the net. I'm sure that Hornquist was screaming his lungs out that he had position in front of Holtby, and all he had to do is just get that puck anywhere near the net.
Forsling continues to pile up the assists. And he's doing it at even strength. One of the best in the NHL. What a find on waivers by the Panthers, then re-signed this offseason. They're thrilled to have him. Ole Yulevi's got a chance. He'll fire blocked away. Gets it right back. Traffic in front. He's trying to get it to the front of the net again. Yulevi holding. Now they give to Vetrano off his stick, though. He gets hit to the boards by Hakanpää. And Radifaksa. Lead pass tipped away. Oh, Vetrano all over with Hakanpää back at the blue line. Now Vetrano breaks in. He fires Holtby the save. He and Hakanpää were going at it, the two of them. Play Vetrano and Tippett have both had some real good chances tonight.
They're using their speed, keeping their feet moving, driving towards the net and getting in the scoring position.
Barkov moves it ahead. Knocked off his stick, then he goes down. Roppel got a stick in on him. Meager with a solid hit on Roppel, and Barkov clears it out. Panthers have had three leads tonight. Hammond breaks in, puts it in front. Deflected puck went wide. He was looking for Barkov. Ekblad resets it at center ice. Both Forsling and Gudas get assists on the Hornquist goal. There's Mammon putting the pressure on. Gudas at the line. He'll shoot, but that puck did come out of the zone. So offside call. Goals keep on coming for the Cats. Averaging six a game during the winning streak. They're halfway there already.
On that Panthers go-ahead goal here in the second period. But he's known for the hits and the clean hits and the physicality. Second in the NHL in hits so far this season. That was before we started tonight's game. Gudas has got, I think, three hits so far.
He's going a pretty good offensive pace this year. You know, nine assists in his 32 games. You project that out. Nice number for Ratko Gudas. He and Forsling been that steady second pair for the Panthers. Here's Duclair in the offensive zone, setting up Forsling. He shoots, gloved. Now the Panthers have done a good job in transition in this game tonight as they're the number one rush team in the NHL. We look at the ozone time, you see heavily favoring the Panthers, and there are the rush chances. Add in Verhaeghe off the rush, drawing both penalties. shows where this game has gone, but Dallas only down by a goal. Had some shots here in the second. Hintz with the hit. Hintz puts it in front. And it comes through to Heiskanen. Centering pass, loose in the slot. Weegar taps it ahead. Here's Anton Lundell breaking over the blue line. Weegar picks it up. Weegar shooting, save Holtby. And Hintz is on the rebound.
Another scoring chance by the Panthers because the defensemen activate. Weegar stepping up, jumping into the play.
Bobrovsky able to pop out and cut that off for Weegar, but unable to clear the zone. Now Weegar has a man at center. Duclair floats it cross ice. Puck couldn't handle it. Radulov is back there to help out. 3-2 Panther lead. Barkov twice and Hornquist, the Florida goal scorers tonight. This is icing.
You know, when the Panthers are, when they go to play other teams, the other coaches talk about the five-man rush that the Panthers possess. And here's an example. We talked about Weegar. Look at, he just gets that puck to Lundell, and then he just busts his butt up to the right-hand side, gets into the open ice, receives the pass, makes sure he gets it on net, hoping for a juicy rebound. Big part of the Panthers' success this year.
Off the draw, here's a shot. Bobrovsky fights it off. Lostarinen ahead for Hornquist. Caught a sweep it to Lomberg, but Gurianov was aware. Now Jamie Benn ahead for Sagan. Knocked away by Olajuwon. Here comes Lomberg the other way. Lomberg will shoot. Saved by Holtby, and then he paddles the rebound on the tape for Gurianov. He got it to center. Benn knocked away. Forsling, lead feed for Hornquist. Took a hit as he sent it on goal. Joe Thornton after the puck. He's checked by Sagan. Now tip it off the bench. And Vetrano on the loose chain. Vetrano knocked down. Stays with it. Harley was hit solidly by Tippett as he cleared the zone. Forsling moves it ahead again. Vetrano floats it towards the net. Forsling quickly around the boards. It comes all the way down. Barkov chasing Klingberg, but it's icing.
Panthers not spending too much time in their own zone now. The Dallas Stars trying to establish some kind of a forecheck. And the Panthers' defense are reading off of that. If they have no play, it's either off the glass or around the boards. And then Panthers rely on those foot races that they've won, the majority of them, tonight against the Stars.
Seven different Panthers with points in the game tonight. Multi-points for Ekblad and Barkov. Glendening behind the Panther net, up to the point. Gudas got a boot on that. That puck goes up and out of play.
And we mentioned about Andrew Burnett and the Panthers. He says, you know, all that success that we've had on home ice, and it's great. We've enjoyed it. Panthers, the players have had fun. He says, we've got to get on the road and establish that kind of dominance away from South Florida.
Mammon out to center and then tangled up. Oh, boy. Raffel and Verhage. There's going to be an interference penalty. And we'll get Verhage.
Florida penalty, 23, 2 minutes interference.
Well, I'm not too sure about this one. Coincidental contact here. Here's Verhage trying to just get some open ice, and yeah, there's the collision. Yeah, maybe from that angle, like Verhage with a little bit of an interference.
Second Dallas power play coming up. Their last power play earlier in the period was wild. Barkov scored shorthanded, and then Gurianov came back with a power play goal.
Yeah, late in their power play, only 9 seconds left.
Sagan on the shoot-in. Bobrovsky put it to the corner, and Ekblad's got it. Lead pass for Lundell. Here he comes. Barkov trailing. Lundell left it for him. Barkov was looking to get to the bench. Durianov drop pass. Lundell picks it up. Now Forsling after the loose puck. Avoided the hit of Ben as he got it up the boards. Dallas trying to hold this puck in. And they do. Sagan for Suter over to Haskinen. Talented young defenseman with a shot off a stick. And that puck out of play.
Again, Lundell getting some quality time on the penalty kill. Now we got a conversation going on and right in front of the Panthers net. And Gudas was involved in that. And Jamie Benn. Conversation there. I'm not quite sure. Not quite sure what language they were speaking.
Well, they were nose to nose, that's for sure. A couple of veteran players there. Puck out to center. Rope hints. Will feed it back as Dallas gets reset. Midway through the hockey game. Panthers have not trailed. Dallas twice as race Florida leads. Now 3-2. Hornquist the go-ahead goal here in the second. Huberto lead pass, Lösterinen one-on-one against Klingberg. Lösterinen knocked away. And Joe Pavelski snaps it the other way. Gudas, oh, big hit on Hintz by Ratko Gudas. Solid work there by Gudas. Here's Lomberg shorthanded breaking in. Gives back to Barkov. He has a chance, deflected away. Barkov trying to play the Karen but couldn't. Verhaeghe's penalty is winding down. Barkov all over Klingberg, not allowing him any space at all. Klingberg will try again. And nothing doing again. He has iced it as the power play ends.
Well, positioning on this penalty kill by the Panthers, not allowing the Dallas Stars to get set up and make some fancy plays. But Ratko Gudas, we just finished talking about one of the hit leaders in the NHL, and here Roope Hintz tried to stop and spin and go the other way, and Gudas timed perfectly. And then you see the result.
Ratko Gudas just brings that positivity and that off the ice, and just that attitude on the ice, something the Panthers forever were missing. Lundell wins the faceoff. Huberto sets up Montour, shot. Knocked down at the net. Duclair trying to get a hold of it behind. It comes up the boards. Montour lets it go through. Jonathan Huberto. One assist already tonight. Makes a move into the slot. Knocked away. Huberto so strong. Able to get it back. Duclair. Pass in front deflected. Anton Lundell. Back for Ylevi. Moves it quickly. Montour. Quality shift in the offensive zone by Florida. All five have gotten a touch. Here's Duclair leaving it for Ylevi. His wrister goes wide. And now Haskinen will get out to center ice. Moves it to the wing. The Stars are offside. We've got 8:19 left in the second period. The Panthers up a goal in Dallas, having some fun.
On home ice, and that is the puck management and the way that they can get control. We saw that in that last shift with the Panthers with all five players touching the puck, keeping their feet moving, getting into those open areas. Dallas has a little difficulty organizing their defensive responsibilities, and if the Panthers continue to create those chances, they should be able to capitalize.
Panthers with 29 shots on goal already, just a little over halfway through the game. Last two games, they put up 45 and 48 shots. That against Calgary and Montreal. Both victories. Scored 5 and 6 goals in those games. They're at 3 tonight. Here's Ben, loved by Bobrovsky.
Sergei Bobrovsky with that record that he has on home ice, I mean, trying to build more success away from South Florida.
Well, he was great the other night after Calgary got that 2-1 lead on the Panthers. He just slammed the door, and over that winning streak at home, he's got a .938 save percentage. Unfortunate that second Dallas goal just kind of squeaked by him and then tapped in at the goal line by Gurianov, but the Panthers have given him the lead again. Bouncing puck at the Dallas line, Mannin got a stick on it, but they'll say he's offside.
Maxime Mannin has opened up some eyes, not only for the Panthers management and coaching staff, but the fans as well. He was one of their top player for the Panthers in that recent four-game homestand. Getting an opportunity to play with Barkov and seizing that opportunity. I mean, he's using the size and the skating ability to gain the zone and hang on to that puck.
Rides Roffel to the end boards. Barkov is there getting a stick on it. Mannin reversed it. Haskinen pinches in for Dallas. Feeds it into the circle. Foxa. Centering pass. Glendening just missed wide. Luke Glendening's had a couple of good chances in this game tonight. Rare sustained zone time tonight for Dallas, but now it's out. Haven't seen it very often. Haskinen in the neutral zone. Carries down the wing. Centering pass was blocked away by Forslund. Robertson gives to Pavelski. Now Haskinen one-timer. Bobrovsky makes the stop.
Little turnover in the neutral zone and the attack by all five Dallas Stars. And once they get control and they push it back to the point, the one-timer that Bobrovsky's got to come across, and we'll see the technique right here. Right exactly where he wants to be at the top of the blue paint in that goal crease.
And we'll do it again in the faceoff circle. And you saw, you know, Dallas is so good in the circle. Panthers done a decent job tonight. But, you know, after those faceoffs, try to have players jump in and get to the puck. And we saw Lomberg do it there. Pavelski tries to pull it back. There's Lomberg again, bothering the puck holder. But Klingberg works it free. Here's the shot, and they score! And Dallas has tied it at three.
Well, we just talked about it. One of the best faceoff teams in the NHL. And this time, the Dallas Stars, right off the faceoff. That's Pavelski. There's full control, and then you'll see them go right to the front of the net. And that's redirected off the far post.
Third time tonight, Dallas has come back. Looked like Hintz may have got the stick on it in front. Two goals just like that, off faceoffs, and then deflected in.
Now, talking to a number of the media members of the Dallas Stars, they said a lot of their offense, especially on home ice with the record that they have, that's exactly the way that they're scoring goals so far this year, and winning those draws in the offensive zone with full possession.
Now Gurianov sends one wide of the Panther net. Suter in front, the pass, the shot high from Sagan. Olajuwon took the hit from Sagan, gets it over to Lundell. He takes a hard shoulder. Chance in front, and Sagan scores! And Dallas leads 4-3.
Well, this one's come off the turnover. Panthers defense had activated, and they thought that full control that they were going to get up the ice after the shot over top of the net. Here's Jonathan Huberto. You don't see this very often. Goes off the end of his stick. Panthers have already been up the ice. And a beautiful move by Tyler Sagan. Quick to the backhand. Bobrovsky committed himself.
Two goals in 28 seconds for Dallas. Sagan has given the Stars their first lead of the night after Hintz tied it. Boy, oh boy. Panthers have allowed four.
That's how quickly the teams can strike against you. The first goal was a face-off loss and a redirection, and then that one, unfortunate turnover in the offense or in the defensive zone. And we haven't seen that happen lately for the Florida Panthers, especially on that four-game homestand, and you see the reaction there on the Panther bench.
Well, this red-hot number one offense in the NHL is going to have to do it again tonight. They've gotten three already, but it's not enough. Hintz is 13th of the year, and then Sagan with his ninth. And both scored at even strength. Here comes Verhaeghe the other way. Pass in front, blocked away by Haskinen. Verhaeghe gets it right back, looking for Barkov behind the net. Comes up the boards, though, to Raffel. Clears the center. Haskinen moves in. Haskinen with a chance. Bobrovsky fights it off with the blocker. Verhaeghe chips it out to center. Mammon picks up the loose puck. Mammon couldn't get a shot away. Two stars were on him. Gudas all the way back. Verhaeghe sweeps it ahead to center. And the Stars control. Verhaeghe at the blue line. Here comes Tippett with a shot, saved by Holtby. Panthers trying to hold it in the zone. Barkov's got it. Forsling moves in, winds up with a big blast. Deflected away. Forsling again, put it behind the net, Verhaeghe. Verhaeghe settles it down. Down low, Joe Thornton. Left it in the corner. Thornton after it again. Thornton's got it. Centering pass, Mitrano. Shot blocked. And it carries out. Swept ahead. And it bounces to Hakanpää. Goes off the boards to the Panther line. Forsling has it taken away. Robertson moves in. Gudas is there defensively. Robertson still with it, though. Double team. Thornton trying to knock it away. Rolls to the end boards. Radulov puts it out in front. Joe Thornton is there. Toronto trying to get out of the zone, he does. Well, picked up by Hintz. And now it's Robertson. Down low, Hintz, one hands it towards the net. Puck battle in the Panthers zone again. Toronto is there, Liddell battles Robertson. Robertson walks off the wall, gets into the slot. Feed over to Klingberg, Dallas winning some 50-50s now. Suter shoots, pass save, Bobrovsky. Panthers desperate for a clear. Still can't get it. Hintz again. Finally taken away by Lundell. Backhands off the glass.
Now the Panthers a little difficulty coming out of their own zone very smoothly right now. The pressure is Dallas is smelling a little blood. They're committing two forecheckers on the Florida Panthers. Panthers defense have got to move the puck as quickly as they can out of their own zone.
Panthers now down a goal in Dallas.
Now an important draw back in their own zone. The ice has been tilted a little bit.
Gurianov got the only assist on that Sagan goal. He was all alone in front of the Panther net. But adversity never bothers this Panther team. In fact, it usually makes them dig in even more. Lead the league in third period comebacks. Right now, down a goal late in the second. Osterinen takes away. Lead pass, Hornquist deflects it in the zone. Lomberg charging it after it. Hornquist knocks it off Suter's stick. Worked along the boards. Lomberg. Trying to get a hold of it. It comes back to Weegar. He'll let one go wide. And now Klingberg trying to clear. Lomberg knocks it down. Lomberg in front. Hornquist just couldn't settle it down. What a shift by this line. Weegar holds it in the zone beautifully. Weegar on that backhand in behind for Loesterinen. Carries out the other side. Now Weegar high slot. Looking for a chance. He shoots. He scores! Mackenzie Weegar! What a shift by the Panthers, and we're four apiece.
Well, we're getting used to that energy line with Hornquist out there, Loisterinen and Lomberg. They were causing all kinds of chaos in the Dallas zone, jumping on those loose pucks, being physical. And how about the activation there of Mackenzie Weegar? He just never bailed out the blue line. He just found some open ice, and here's the result. There's a screen out in front of who else but Hornquist, and off the inside post, Holtby. You see him bobbing around, trying to track that puck down, just a little too late.
The coaches may not like it, but everybody watching loves it. 4-4 now. The Panthers respond less than 4 minutes after Sagan gave Dallas its first lead of the night. Weegar's second of the year. And the work on that shift by Lomberg and Loisterinen and Hornquist. Something else. Loose in the Panthers zone. Barkov picks up the loose puck. Lead pass deflected all the way down off the Dallas stick. Backs in to Schenner. Now it's Haskinen moving over the line. Ole Yalevi back there for the Panthers. Lost it. Haskinen trying to get it in front. There's the shot. Save Bobrovsky. He's got to cover up.
Again, the Dallas is getting into some open areas and firing at will. Now they're up to 27 shots on goal. And the Panthers again with another defensive zone faceoff.
So Ekblad and Weegar will come right back on the ice in their own zone. Lundell will take the draw for Florida. Stars win it. Haskinen shoots. Bobrovsky the save. Now Lundell backhands out. Bounces at center. Mammon moved it ahead. Verhaeghe is there. Mammon holds it in. Maxime Mammon, nice move to get by Robertson. Mammon gives it back for Weegar. Weegar will shoot again. Three along the boards. Lundell on the loose puck. Turns, couldn't get a shot on goal. Loisterinen got the only assist on that last goal. Owen Tippett picks up the loose puck at center. Now Verhaeghe at the line. Cross ice feed. It's Joe Thornton. Has to track it down in the corner. Peterson gets hit solidly by Tippett, and Thornton gets a stick on it. Now Radulov. Close in on a minute to go in the second period. Chance here. Bobrovsky with a big save there on Peterson, who got free. Peterson still with the puck. Now it's Radulov. Pass in front, blocked by Forsling. Dallas's fourth line with a little pressure. Peterson. Petrano after it again. Hockenbaugh pinching in, keeps it in the zone. Gudas hit behind the net. Evie Ranta on the loose puck. Jammed up there by Forsling. It comes free in front, and Bobrovsky will cover up.
Well, the pressure here by the Dallas Stars in the last minute and forces Sergei Bobrovsky to make another key save. There's the shot. Bobrovsky now way out of his crease. Many shots on goal in the second period for the Dallas Stars.
Another high event game. But this time, unlike the other night where Calgary only got two goals, Dallas does have four. Panthers dump it out to center. Here's that Loisterinen line on again. Well-deserved shift, although Barkov is at center, so he took the faceoff in the D zone. And Lomberg and Hornquist are out there with him. Weegar over to play it. Panthers trying to clear. Ekblad gets it ahead. And we will go to the third period. All tied up.
Another wild period the Panthers involved in. This time on the road. 8 goals scored.
Second intermission coming up. We'll chat momentarily with Carter Verhaeghe of the Panthers. All the highlights in a wild second period. And a closer look at Joe Thornton playing his 1,700th game tonight, only the sixth NHLer to reach that mark. But once again here tonight, Randy, wide open, a lot of offense. Let's go downstairs. Carter Verhaeghe is going to join us. And Carter, what did Dallas start to get done in that second period after it seemed like possession time and offensive zone time, you really controlled the first?
Yeah, I mean, they got some good chances, and we gave up a little too much, and they got pretty fortunate on their chances and buried them, so we got to bear down a little bit here.
Carter, is it puck possession? Is it puck management that do you think the coaches will remind you here in the second intermission?
Yeah, I think so. I think we got to kind of keep it simple and kind of limit their chances a little bit. I mean, we're in a bit of a run-and-gun game right now, and we kind of want to settle down a little bit.
What has been so good? You've been a great third-period team all season long. What has been the biggest factor in that success? What are you looking for tonight?
I mean, I think when it comes to the third and it comes to winning games, we know how to do it. So I think we've got a lot of good leadership in the team, and I think we're going to do that tonight.
I look forward to watching it. Carter, thanks for the time. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Carter Verhaeghe joining us between our second and third periods tonight here on Pally Sports. Couple of goals for Barkov. Hornquist has one. The offense keeps on coming. Third period coming up. Even game at four apiece. Let's go places. Back in Dallas, should be a great third period. 4-4 in this game. We've gone back and forth. Let's go back in time here in Dallas. We go into the virtual vault. Alexander Barkov's first game as a Panther. He got his first goal in the third period. Tom Gilbert, Jonathan Huberdeau got the assist. The Panthers went on to win 4-2 when Marcel Gotch scored a couple for the Cats. Look at the young Barkov and Huberdeau as well.
18 years old, Alexander Barkov. Wasn't the prettiest goal, but he'll take it. Well, you know Barkov's going to be front and center in this third period. Panthers still coming back onto the ice, getting ready for this third.
Yes, line's been terrific tonight. There's a look at Barkov's franchise numbers. Now in his ninth year, he's had four shots on goal. So has Verhaeghe. Mammon's had a couple of shots as well. Attempts. Big third period coming up. Panthers had three leads. Dallas was able to come back. Dallas had one lead. The Panthers came back.
Yeah, back and forth. Six goals in that second period. Carter Verhaeghe. Panthers will count on his speed to drive outside. As I mentioned just moments ago, the Panthers, they can draw some penalties with their speed. 1-for-2 so far in the power play.
And Verhaeghe's been able to do that, draw a couple of penalties off the rush. He has two scoring chances off the rush tonight as well. And as we spoke to him in the second intermission, you hear it in his voice. This Panther team just never gets deterred. Very confident bunch in the third period. Very confident when behind.
Yeah, and I love, you know, being around the team like you and I have been, and the positivity of this team. They like to play with each other and perform and have that success. And there's no negativity in this team at all.
What a great find in free agency Verhaeghe was. He's played 75 games as a Panther. He has 26 goals and 62 points. Last season and this season, here he is putting it in front. The backhand attempt by Mammon was blocked. Here's Verhaeghe wrapping it around. It comes to the boards. Aaron Ekblad is on it. Penalty coming up on Dallas. Again, that Barkov line with Verhaeghe. They work down low. They draw another penalty.
Penalty, number 12, slashing.
Again, the Panthers, they're just boot, scoot, and boogie in the offensive zone, keeping their feet moving. And there's the slash hold. Yeah, there's the slash right there. In fact, a little frustration as Barkov was able to beat him off the boards.
Got his money's worth, held the stick, and then broke it. Panther power play is on, looking for the lead in the third. Hornquist in front of the net. Got a two-point game, goal and an assist. Here's Ekblad over to Duclair. Back it goes for Aaron Ekblad. Knocked away by Pavelski. Huberdeau keeps it in the zone and gets it all the way around to Duclair. He's pressured. Free puck along the wall. Ekblad holds it in. Duclair goes for Huberdeau in the slot. Knocked away. Barkov cleans it up. Bouncing puck again, and this time Pavelski cleans.
Well, and you notice the little difference in the strategy of the Dallas Stars. They're not allowing the Panthers that full control. They are going to take chances and put the pressure on the puck carrier.
Second straight game, Patrick Hornquist with multiple points. Duclair gives back to Ekblad at the line. Now it's Huberdeau. Swings it. Barkov hustles over to play it. Here's Barkov with two tonight. Cross ice, Huberdeau in front. He couldn't get it to Duclair. They try that extra pass. It did not click. And Huberdeau and Barkov and the others go to the bench. Ekblad stays on in control of the puck. Now Montour on the ice to run the power play with 35 seconds to go. Too far for Verhaeghe, and it's icing.
A couple of little miscues there as the Panthers, you know, they're passing coming out of their own zone. They want to back off that Dallas defense and see if they can get into the offensive zone with ease and then post up and then make their little plays. And now they're back in their own zone.
Had that zone time, looked like some chances on some setups, but no shots against Holtby. Owen Tippett moved it ahead to Lundell, and he'll shoot in. Holtby was able to get a stick on it. Tippett battling behind the net. It comes around the boards. Lundell reverses it for Thornton. Jumbo Joe gives back to the line for Brandon Montour. Now it's Anton Lundell moving in, letting one go high. Carries around, and it caught a stanchion in the glass and allowing Dallas to clear, and that's it for the man advantage. Panthers now 1-for-3 tonight. They remain even, 2.5 gone by here in the third. Lundell sent it ahead off the glove of Vetrano. Panthers clear it down the ice. Gudas at the red line, ahead for Lostarinen. Makes a nice move, keeps possession, gives back to Gudas. He'll let her wrist shot go. That's blocked by Klingberg in front. Lostarinen's had a solid game here tonight. There's another shot, that one by Forsling that went wide. Buck loose along the boards, Gurianov. Checked by Lomberg. Lomberg continues to work against Sagan. Puck free behind the net. Klingberg's got it, checked by Vetrano. Now Ben just has to throw it out of there. Panthers in possession again. Now Barkov on the ice with Huberdeau and Duclair. Here comes Sasha. Down the wing, drop pass, Duclair. Look, centering feet, he's got Weegar. He'll give it back to Aaron Ekblad. Duclair again for Ekblad. Weegar looking for a shooting lane, blocked by Raffel.
Well, the Panthers, they got to be selfish here. If they got an opportunity, especially when the Panthers have numbers in front of the Dallas goal, they've got to get it out in front.
Barkov settles it down. Stays after it. But it's scooped up now by Raffel. Gets the center ice. Weegar able to get free. Weegar with a nice move, flips it out to center for Ekblad. Look out, Weegar picks it up now. Lead pass for Verhaeghe breaking in. Verhaeghe will circle it back. Goes down low, Lundell. Tied up by Suter. Anton Lundell continues to work. Lundell emerges with the puck and carries over to Verhaeghe, centering pass block. And now the Stars finally will get it clear to center. Radulov, though, could not get in over the line. Still no shots on goal either way in this third period. Here comes Lundell with speed. Walking in and shooting. That one just skipped wide. Put back in front of the net. Good effort defensively and spending time in the zone by the Panthers here in the third. Dallas looking for a chance. Roope Hintz speeds in. Hintz puts it in front. Hornquist with a good defensive play. Battle with Pavelski. Haskinen knocked away, and Hornquist will clear to center ice. Lostarinen finds Weegar. Steps in over the Dallas line. Hornquist works behind the net. Taken away. Cleared up the boards for Hintz. Clearing pass blocked by Vetrano. Robertson lays it ahead. Hintz blocked by Weegar. Roope Hintz one more time in the Panther zone. Put right in front. It came all the way through the slot. Thornton with a steal. And Vetrano. Trying to get the legs going to center, but that puck rolled on him.
On the last couple of shifts, the Panthers changing up. They put the Huberto up with Barkov.
Bobrovsky way out of his net. Lost it to Gurianov. He's in behind the net. Puts it out in front and they score. Jamie Benn makes it 5-4.
For the love of Yeehaw Junction. Dallas gets the puck in deep. And Jamie Benn is the one that was wide open out in front. Here's Bobrovsky's got to come out. Tries to feed it to Forsling, and now he's caught no man's land. And by the time the Panthers try to recover, Jamie Benn all by himself for the go-ahead goal here in the third.
The first shot on goal for either team in the third period. And the only look at the Panther net all period for Dallas. They've got the lead again off the Bobrovsky giveaway.
Well,
icing is the call.
We go back. You know, even though Sergei Bobrovsky made a mistake and the puck, he was trying to, he got intercepted. But the Panthers should have come right down the middle of the ice back in their own zone. They should have been able to recover defensively, but they just got caught eyeing the man behind the net with the puck. And that was Roope Hintz.
Second time tonight, the Panthers have trailed. Barkov in a board battle on his own end. Help there from Huberto. Weegar will carry again. Anthony Duclair circles away from Glendening. Another move by Duclair, then shoved off the puck by Glendening. Now the foot race is on. Duclair against Glendening. We got a penalty. And I got to call it on Anthony Duclair for interference. Stars will get a power play. Up 5-4.
Number 10, 2 minutes interference.
Of the Florida Panthers, who are up against it now, down a goal and short-handed here in the third.
Wow, we'll take a look at this, and I mean, you decide. It's a 50-50 race for that puck. Duclair, Glendening. Duclair comes in. He's got positioning, plays the puck, and he gets called for interference. I'm not in agreement with that call.
Now, the first arm that went in was from Glendening, and Duclair is the one that went down. In any event, third power play of the night for Dallas. They're 1-for-2. Panthers need the stops here from Bobrovsky badly. Pavelski takes a shot high and wide. Carries out towards the line. Barkov picks it up there. Barkov makes a move at the line, still with it. But Dallas was back defensively. Should I say Lundell controls? And they'll kill some time now. Lundell and Barkov combined for one shorthanded goal earlier in the game. Here's Barkov. Out ahead for Lundell. 1-on-3, he'll dump in and the Panthers get a four-man change. Gurianov, the assist on the Benn goal. He also assisted on the 4-3 goal by Sagan, and Dennis Gurianov has a three-point game tonight. Here's Benn. Rolled it up towards the line. Dangerous pass there, but Dallas able to control. Klingberg kept it in, knocked away by Huberto. Huberdeau moves ahead. Lostarinen going to the net. Huberdeau, the pass. Lostarinen shorthanded. Knocked down at the goal. And saved by Holtby. Huberdeau is looking for the rebound.
Well, it looked like there was some tired Dallas Stars, Jamie Benn and Klingberg, because they basically gave up on this. Here's the intercepted pass by Huberdeau, and now the race is on. You see Lostarinen going right down the middle of the ice. Huberdeau buys time, a beautiful pass. And Lostarinen was able to get the shot. Holtby looking behind him. That's never good for a goaltender to do. And somewhere it's underneath this paraphernalia of equipment.
First shot on goal of the period for the Panthers comes a little more than 8 minutes in. Dallas has only had one shot as well. That was the goal to give him the lead. Lomberg on the PK here. Watching Suter will now shoot in. Lundell got there ahead of Ben. Strong work again by Anton Lundell. Haskinen over to Gurianov. Round for Pavelski, hit by Lostarinen and solidly. Forsling trying to dig it out of there. Lostarinen has it pinned to the wall with his skate. And the linesman yelling, moving along. Big battle along the boards. Deep in the Panther zone. Penalty is over. Duclair is out of the box. Suter, though, has a chance. And that one just went wide. Pavelski was looking for a deflection. One of the best ever at doing that at the net. Panthers with a good penalty kill. They don't allow a shot on goal.
And both teams 1-for-3 in the power play. Panthers have that shorthanded goal.
Good anticipation and steal by Huberdeau, but it was jumping on him and then knocked away.
Yeah, again, we're seeing Huberdeau taking the place of Maxime Mammon on that Barkov line.
Big hit there on Montour. Panthers get it out to center. Barkov has Montour jumping up. Played it to the boards for Duclair. In behind the net, it's Barkov. Hit by Hockenpuck. Uyghur with a big hit. And then Uyghur battles Faxa. Round it comes. Radulov is there. Leaves it to the point man. Three along the boards. Lindell pinches in. Reverses it again. Dallas just sending it back around each way, holding it in the Panthers zone.
Yeah, the Panthers, you see Duclair. He's still on the ice from after he came out of the penalty box.
To a side in the corner now in the Panther zone. Uyghur gets it free to Montour, but again, Dallas keeps it in. Finally, Uyghur will lift this puck down the ice, and it will roll for icing, so they're unable to get the full change.
Now that's a disadvantage for the Panthers. I mean, Uyghur, he tried to lift it in the air. No intention of trying to ice that puck. The Panthers might have to take a timeout here. We've got some tired players on the ice. Now it looks like the officials are allowing them a partial change. Duclair's still out on the ice. Barkov, so that forward line with Huberdeau, Barkov, and Duclair.
And Uyghur's still out there also. Ben pulls it back. Sagan shot blocked. Gurianov. And finally, they get a regular whistle with no icing, and they can change. But 9:09 to go in this quick-moving third period. Panthers down a goal. Road again on Saturday night. A road ahead brought to us by Toyota, and then return for three games back at FLA Live Arena, where they've won 18 of 21 this season. Lundell with Verhaeghe and Mammon now on the ice.
The Panthers have been in this position before.
Tie for the league lead in third period comeback wins with 6. Columbus has done it as well. Panthers trying to spend some time in the Dallas end, but won't do it there. As Gurianov got it to the line and then out. And here comes Gurianov, but it's knocked away. Verhaeghe Three stars are back defensively. Verhaeghe stops, sends it in behind. Lundell after it, got tied up. Cleared out to center. Here comes the Losterinen line. And if one line's gonna spend time in the O zone, this would be it. But here the Stars, able to move it ahead for Hintz. Lomberg threw the body in there against him. Lomberg trying to get it out of the zone, he does. Hard work by Ryan Lomberg. Gives to Forsling on the shoot-in.
Let's see if this line can get some forechecking going and regain possession of the puck.
Losterinen along the boards. Lost it to Heiskanen. Pavelski at center. Lead pass. Heiskanen couldn't control. Weegar picks it up. Moving the other way, Mackenzie Weegar. Leaves it for Losterinen. And Hornquist got it back to the blue line. Ratko Gudas with a wrist shot wide. Huberdeau in behind the net. Huberdeau in front. Couldn't get it to Hornquist. Gudas keeps it in. Here's Huberdeau looking to make something happen. Takes a shot wide. Gudas plays the carom. Robertson at the end boards. Huberdeau knocked it away. Forces the turnover. Lindell up the boards. Pavelski and finally tipped out. 7:15 to go. Huberdeau dances one player. Walks in and waits.
Oh,
he dropped it off and gave it away. And Raffel's got a breakaway the other way. In on Bobrovsky. And on the back check, Brandon Montour negates the chance. Great hustle by the Panthers there. Puck still deep in the Panthers zone. Barkov working hard. He gets chopped at by Raffel. Barkov now gives to Huberdeau. And the Panthers break out, but that line has to go to the bench. Verhaeghe back out there. Down low, Tippett couldn't control it. Panthers still stuck on one shot on goal, 13 and a half minutes into this third period. Dallas only has two. Forsling. And the shot by Tippett is stopped.
Well, the Panthers dodge a big bullet there, down by a goal, and you'll see Jonathan Huberdeau just waiting. He just timed it improperly with Montour, and that led to the breakaway, and fortunately the puck just chipped over top of Bobrovsky and the crossbar, but Montour was right there to just disrupt right at the last second. Good hustle there by Brandon Montour.
Off the faceoff. Here's Weegar. Played over on the boards. Tip it. Now it comes over to Joe Thornton. Reverses it, but Toronto had it go off his stick though. Early in the period, Panthers had some zone time. Tried maybe an extra pass here and there. Didn't get shots against Holtby.
I think you're absolutely right, Goldie. The decision not to shoot the puck or get it towards the goal.
And now it looks like it's not going to be a pretty one if they're to get it. Boy, look at Ekblad all tied up there by Hintz up in the neck area. Here comes Mammon breaking in. Knocked off his stick. Player's stick went flying. Stars get another quick clear. And we're down 5:20 to go in the game. Lundell. Duclair. Panthers try to get after it again. But Dallas controls, gets another clear out of the zone. Player hit hard by Foxes. He went down. Forsling trying to get to this puck. He does. He shoots in. Panthers in a change. Stars have time. Weegar got it to Verhaeghe. He shakes free. Verhaeghe trying to beat Heiskanen down the wall. Verhaeghe and knocked away on the back deck by Heiskanen. Dallas has iced it.
You know the strategy for the Dallas Stars now with the pressure the Panthers are coming, all five men, they're just whacking it off the boards, and if they ice the puck, they're going to rely on the success of a penalty, of a faceoff win.
Well, they're going to try to do this for the last four and a half.
Not sure they know who they're dealing with this Panther team. Off the faceoff. Hagee hungry after the puck, gets it to Barkov. Out in front for Hagee, on the backhand, it goes wide. He had a chance. Ekblad moves it ahead. Oh, they say Barkov never got a stick on that to deflect it in, so it's icing on the Panthers.
Yeah, an extra effort here for another scoring chance for Carter Verhaeghe. He's had a handful in this game. He and Barkov teaming up in the Dallas zone. There he chips it, and look at Barkov just lays it out in front because he knows Verhaeghe is going to come right across that high slot area on the backhand. Man, it just didn't get enough on it. Rolled off the end of his stick and sailed wide.
Weegar allows Barkov and Huberdeau to change. Verhaeghe about to head off also. Mattu Lostarina getting by Pavelski. Takes a shot. Holtby makes the save. Panthers need more of that, direct and to the net. 3:56 to go, to the Cats have another comeback in them. Along with Hornqvist and Vetrano on the ice here.
Yeah, right before the break, nice rush as the Dallas Stars going into that 1-2-2. So there's gonna be some open ice in the middle zone, and here's Loiserin, and he drives wide. Shot on goal.
Well, they got the two workers up front, and Vetrano hoping to get free for a shot. There's the very minimal shots on goal here in the third, both ways. Dallas got the goal from Ben to make it 5-4. Lundetting pulled it back. And Hintz will dump it out. Weegar, right up the middle, with speed, takes a shot. Saved by Holtby, Vetrano on the rebound. Weegar in the corner, lays it around the boards. Suter trying to get it out of there, Ekblad, along with Hornqvist, trying to hold it in. Now the Stars do the job. Weegar ahead for Hornqvist, knocked off his stick. Here's Lostarina, gets the red line. Over the Dallas line. Looking, puts it in front for Hagee. Got a pass to Ekblad, that's broken up. Rope hints the other way for Dallas. Able to control that puck. Comes out of the zone though. Less than 3 minutes to go. Huberdeau at center. Lead pass, Barkov. Now it's Verhaeghe walking in. Drop pass, Forsling. Has to track it down and plays it around the boards for Verhaeghe. Bobrovsky's on the bench, Panthers have the extra skater. Montour's shot deflected up and out of play. Six skaters on for Florida, 2:35 to go.
And the faceoff will be in the Dallas zone, and it was a deflected shot that went out of play. Panthers take their timeout. See the players that are huddling around, and that's what they're drawing up here is if they win the draw and they practice these certain plays when they have the extra attacker on, and if they got full control off that faceoff, they see if they try and execute one really good shot on goal. But the onus goes on winning the draw with the possession. You can scramble the draw because you have an extra player on the ice. The Panthers are going to have to bust that face-off circle. Get that possession back.
Dallas, as we talked about before the game, very good in the circle. A couple of their plays created two of their deflected goals tonight. So Barkov, Huberdeau, Verhaeghe, and Hornqvist with Weegar and Ekblad. There's Huberdeau and Ekblad having the conversation.
Get possession, get Hornqvist in front of the net. Plenty of time to work with here, 2.5 minutes.
Ben, 7 of 9 in the circle tonight, will take the faceoff against Barkov, who's taken a ton of them this evening, 33 faceoffs. Loose at the dot, and Huberdeau steps in to pick it up. Here's Weegar. Hecklef holds, waits, got to go cross ice, knocked out of the air. Barkov quickly back to Weegar. He'll take a shot, knocked down in front. Ekblad at the dock, settles it down. Ekblad shoots, deflected in front. Barkov, Huberdeau and Barkov play a little catch. Hornquist out in front of the net. Can they get it there? Here's Weegar. Shooting, saved by Holtby. Trying to cover up, he couldn't do it. Puck is loose, Barkov jumps on it. Tries to get it back to the point, knocked away. Panthers hold it in. Hornquist for Ekblad, he moves in. In front, Barkov, oh, what a save by Holtby. He got over with the left pad, Barkov again on the doorstep. Here's Huberdeau in front. Ekblad couldn't get a shot on goal. Great chances for the Panthers. Barkov had one towards the empty net, and it's wide. And it's icing on Dallas with 1:38 left.
Well, excellent execution by the Panthers here. When they win that draw, they had two chances, and then we'll take a look here at the best chance that they had. Hornquist over to Ekblad, and watch, he'll find Barkov there for the one-timer and that left pad of Holtby. If Barkov elevates that puck, it will sail right over that pad. He had the open short side.
Panthers control it again off the draw. Here's Jonathan Huberdeau shooting, and that one deflected and goes up and out of play.
And look at Hornquist, he is upset.
Oh, and then Ben just gave him a shoulder as he skated by.
Yeah, Hornquist had his stick knocked, slashed out of his hands as he was trying to establish position in front. And yeah, you can read his lips. Boy, that mouth guard is taking a workout.
Same six, stay on for the Panthers. Again, they control off the draw. Here's Jonathan Huberdeau. Back it goes for Ekblad. He'll wind up with a slap shot, deflected wide. Huberdeau fed it around to Barkov. Barkov gets away from Hintz. Here's Huberdeau at the goal line. Looking up at the clock. Back it goes for Weegar. He waits. Huberdeau in front. Barkov tries a pass that's broken up. They try to go across the goal mouth. Couldn't get it to a man, less than a minute to go. It's Weegar at the Dallas line, and they're offside.
Oh. Panthers just a little too aggressive as Weegar made one little extra stick handle as he got to that blue line. He had full control. Now the faceoff's gonna come outside the Dallas blue line.
And they've got a change now. That group had been on the ice for about a minute 45. Huberdeau does stay on, though. So do Weegar and Ekblad. Mammon comes on the ice, fresh legs. Mammon in on the forecheck. But the Stars clear it down, it'll be icing again. 43 and a half to go.
And Barkov and Hornquist jump right back over the boards.
And so does Verhaeghe, quick breather.
But the Panthers have won three consecutive offensive zone draws to get possession here with the net empty with Bobrovsky on the bench.
And they do it again. Aaron Ekblad, 40 seconds to go, over to Huberdeau. Huberdeau shoots, knocked down in front for Higgy. Oh my goodness, Braden Holtby. How did he get that one with the glove? What a save to keep Dallas up a goal. Panthers thought they tied it. Hornquist just
again, the setup there. Exactly what they want. Huberdeau takes the shot. All kinds of chaos in front, and there's Verhaeghe. He was just eyeing a wide open goal, and he just drifts it right into the glove of Holtby.
Oh. 35 seconds to go. Huberdeau jumps on the loose puck again. Huberdeau's got it again, top of the circle, shoots it, scores! They tied it! Hooby-dooby-doo! The comeback Cats do it again with 28.5 to go! It's 5-all!
And you go back earlier in this third period and back in the second period where the Dallas Stars were dominating with the face-off wins, with their four straight face-off wins for the Panthers. Barkov leans in, Then here's Huberdeau. He plays his catch with Ekblad and then fires that shot right over the glove of Holtby. There's another look at it. Hornquist in front, taking the eyes away from the Dallas netminder, and we're tied.
He continues his great season. Huberdeau, another multi-point game. Hornquist giving him a pat there on the bench. We are five apiece as we wind down here in the third. Mammon with a takeaway. Mammon puts it in front. Loose puck chip just wide by Lomberg. Mammon still on the forecheck. Dallas able to get it up the boards and out to center. Less than 10 to go. The Panthers with all kinds of pressure in the final minutes. Finally, Huberdeau beats Holtby. And we are going overtime here in Dallas. The Panthers come from behind. They'll try to finish it up in OT next. Tied.
How impressive the desperation in the dying seconds here. Jonathan Huberdeau assisted on Barkov's power play goal to open up here this game for a 1-0 lead, and there it is. When you give talent that much time, and Huberdeau had taken that shot numerous times during this game, and there's your game-tying goal. Beautiful setup there. Ekblad gets the primary assist, and the Panthers gain a point, and there's still 1 point on the table.
You know, and in essence, you saw Hornquist in front of the net. He's been in on 4 of the 5 goals. He scored one, assisted on the other, and 2 others. He was right out in front of the net screening the goal.
Well, and that's why when teams are down and they pull their goaltender and they take a timeout, they talk about what they want to accomplish on the ice. And the Panthers, they had for that full 2.5 minutes before they tied it up, they had numerous opportunities because of that puck possession. Now they'll go to 3-on-3 OT.
Panthers only allowed 2 shots on goal to Dallas in the third. Outshot them 9-2. Here we go at 5 apiece. Huberdeau, Ekblad, and Barkov get the first chance to try to end it. What a game again. Barkov has 2 goals tonight. Gives to Huberdeau. Down the boards, he goes for Ekblad. He spins with it. Ekblad back for Barkov. Oh, the pass, though, behind Huberdeau. And Dallas has possession. Haskinen. Leaves it. Horatic Coxon. And back for Haskinen. He has to come out of the zone. Dallas got a couple of players changed. Ekblad able to get off the ice. And Huberdeau able to get off as well. Barkov still out there. The dangerous Roope Hintz breaks in. Barkov still can't get off the ice. Nice spin there by Robertson to get over the Panther line. Robertson will let one go, and that up and out of play.
Yeah, the Panthers pretty good positioning there, that 3-on-3 overtime, that previous shift here, not allowing Dallas, even though they allowed them to come into the offensive zone, but there was no option, so they had to wheel back in the neutral zone. Now the Panthers get a full change. They'll have Verhaeghe, Lundell, and Forsling.
Dale against the veteran Jamie Benn at the dot. Sagan jumps in and he plays it off the draw, puts it out in front. He couldn't find Benn. Lundell trying to move by Jamie Benn. Lundell down the wing. Centering pass blocked. He gets it back, leaves it for Verhaeghe. Verhaeghe lost it though. Minute and a half gone and 3-on-3 overtime. Panthers trying to make it 5 straight wins. Klingberg. Back for Benn, he shoots. Bobrovsky fought it off with the blocker. Sagan checked by Lundell. Puck squirts free to Petrano. Tried to chip it out, but he gave it away. Gurianov, who's had a big game tonight, puts the brakes on. Gets to the forehand. Hands it over to Klingberg. Makes a move to the front of the net, it's knocked away. Klingberg able to track it down though. Now it's Hintz, cutting through a little traffic there. Gurianov will walk back to his own zone. Now Gurionov with speed gets in against Petrano. Gurionov shoots, so Bobrovsky makes the save right along the post and drops it off. And Dallas has possession again. Look out now. These three Panthers have been out there for a while. Hintz shoots wide. Pavelski, fresh legs on the ice. Centering pass, it got through. Robertson stopped by Bobrovsky. Panthers best desperate for some possession or a whistle, but they still can't get the change. Now Lundell goes to the bench. It creates a 3-on-2. Lostarinen comes on and joins the play. Try to knock it free, but he went down. Haskinen makes a move, gives it back. On the perimeter, Robertson again. Here's Pavelski getting out behind the net. The wraparound attempt saved by Bobrovsky.
Yeah, that's the best freeze of the puck that the Panthers can count on here in the overtime. They had to get those players off the ice for Toronto. And here's the last. Pavelski goes back behind the net, and you see Bobrovsky come across. And more importantly, stays against his pad so we get a whistle.
Now four saves for Bobrovsky in overtime. Now Barkov, Huberdeau, and Ekblad are back on. Huberdeau trying to chase after this loose puck. Ekblad trying to get a chance here. Won't be able to play it over the boards. Haskinen hit solidly by Ekblad. Puck is free, but it's picked up by Sagan. Sagan moves in. Sagan, oh, what a play by Ekblad to knock it free. Huberdeau, great pass. Barkov on a breakaway. Looking for the hat trick. And it goes high over the net. And then Barkov slammed to the boards. Weegar picks it up at the line. Weegar gets in front. Weegar to Barkov. Backhander just wide off his stick. It's Weegar again. Huberdeau controls. Weegar. Huberdeau again. A minute to go in overtime. Barkov had the chance on the breakaway. Here's Barkov into the Dallas zone. Slowing things down. Weegar again in the slot. Back it goes for Barkov. He waits again. Duclair hops over the boards. Mackenzie Weegar. At the Dallas line, now it's the Duke. Gets the legs going, but he lost it to Sagan. And it swept ahead to Ben. Tired stars out there. Duclair in on the forecheck, 20 to go. Duclair with a shoulder on Haskinen. Verhaeghe puts it out in front, bouncing around, taken away by Ben. He's checked by Verhaeghe. Ben dead tired out there. Verhaeghe nearly had the steal from Holtby. Final seconds, Dallas has a 2-on-1. Sagan moves in, the pass, the shot, oh, it stays out of the net. Bobrovsky came over, and we will go to a shootout, incredible action.
Oh my goodness, scoring chances galore for both teams. It went right down to the wire. Look at Klingberg, he's looking up to the stars. He knew he had the game right on his stick. Here's the defense there by Ekblad, stripping Sagan of the puck. And then look at Jonathan Huberdeau, gives it to Barkov on the breakaway. Holtby with a pad and a blocker save. And Verhaeghe tried to get in as Holtby didn't know what to do with that puck. And there's the last chance. And Barkov, or excuse me, Bobrovsky with the left pad save. I really thought that Barkov was going to finish that game and get his third of the night on the breakaway. What a pass from Jonathan Huberdeau, that spinorama, put it on his stick, in all by himself.
What an exciting game this has been again. After Huberdeau tied it at 19:31 from Ekblad and Barkov. With a goaltender on the bench. So now we get to the shootout. Bobrovsky is 1-1 this year, so is Holtby.
How good was Braden Holtby in this third period in overtime?
Dallas will shoot first. And it will be Joe Pavelski. Two for two this year. Pavelski. 37-year-old Pavelski gets the shootout started. Stops. Oh, and he sneaks it through.
Pavelski tried to get Bobrovsky to move first. Nope. But there was just enough room between the wickets.
Now shooting Florida number 11, Jonathan. Huberdeau will go first for the Panthers. One for three this year. He beat Holtby late in regulation on a slap shot to tie it. See what he has for him now. Nice move, but Holtby stayed with him.
Well, the key on this one, Jonathan Huberdeau, he just ran out of real estate, but Holtby stays back in his crease. Watch him back up, and then rely on just covering the butt along the ice with that pad.
Now, Panthers need a stop here from Bobrovsky against Robertson. Comes in from the left side, and he scores.
Jason Robertson has had success with this move before. He comes in off the left side, left shooter, and he just tucks it right underneath that right pad.
Well, Panthers in a jackpot now. Lundell's got a score just to keep him alive. Lundell speeds in, the rookie in on Holtby, and he stops him, and Dallas wins the shootout. 6-5, the final.
And that's the end of the game. Your final score of the season.
Braden Holtby comes up large. Lundell tried to go five hole as well to extend this shootout. Big hat, but no cattle. And the Stars take this one in the shootout.
That what a game. Some game tonight. Panthers did come back twice. Also lost three leads in the game. They get a point to extend the point streak to five, but Dallas wins it. Plenty more coming up. We'll recap all the highlights. And we'll hear from the dressing room. Panthers Live post game presented by Lexus is next.